getting Facebook up here. Try and get everything all set. All right. So today's webinar is going to be all about exporting your Mobiltech RX estimate into Estify for conversion, and how we have that set up. We worked with Estify to build up some specifics into this. So to start with, we're going to throw up our big crybaby thing. But you're going to see some dollar amounts being thrown around on just sample estimates. Again, we're not telling you that's what you have to charge. We're not saying that's how you should charge or how you should write your estimates. Only thing we're saying is I put something on there to make sure it's understood. So to begin with, we need to be logged in onto our back office portal, which is right on the website. So you're going to go to mobiltechrx.com and you're going to go ahead and log in. And that's going to run you right into your home back office portal screen. So I'm having to take a look at Facebook to make sure I can see what you guys are seeing on the screen. Anytime, if anybody has any questions at all during this thing, we don't have to wait till the end for any Q&A. Just throw it up. If you're watching this on Facebook Live, hit it in the comments. I should see it pop up. If you are in Zoom and watching this, go ahead and throw it up into the Q&A section, and I'll try to make sure and get them answered as we are going. But we're going to be right here in our back office portal. You should have your credit card in. I don't even know if that's a real card. This is an Eric's test account. So we're going to do lots of random stuff into poor Eric's accounts just to show it. So, but you do need to have your credit card in. And then to do the Estify is a separate charge. So it's kind of an expense that we have to pass on to you. We kind of have no choice onto that. So you're going to need to buy an Estify credit to export an estimate. One credit equals one export. We couldn't really come up with a funnier or smarter way to actually label that. So it's just simply a credit, and you will, one credit equals one export. And we worked a pricing structure with Estify. So we're going to be in our back office portal, and it doesn't matter. We can narrow this all the way down here. And this is what it looks like. This is what the screen will look like on your phone. And then we're going to come up here. Oh, I got to figure out where. I don't do this on my phone. Pardon me. Right up into here, into exports. So your tablet is going to look very similar if you're on your, you know, the back end. But no matter what, you're going to go right in here to the exports. So for the sake of this and the fact that I'm a knucklehead, we're going to keep that at a much bigger screen. So you won't have any of these down here, and I'll get to those in just a second. We're going to click the buy credits, and this is going to come bring you in. Now, we also understand that you guys are going to use this mostly in hail work and what you're going to be doing with your hail stuff, where you're going to be exporting it to an estimator and having them load it right into their system. So these export credits do not expire. So they're also not refundable. So make sure you're not clicking on them, you know, all willy-nilly, or having somebody with access to your account. And I don't know why I use the term willy-nilly, but just make sure that what you're doing and when you're purchasing, you understand you are buying this. And one credit, you can buy them singularly or in bulk. So a single credit is $15, and it's going to vary all the way down to $10 per credit. So you can do 5 credits for $70, 10 for $130, 15 for $180, 25 for $275, and 50 for $500. So now if you are working, you know, and you're doing a big storm, you think you're going to need more than 50 credits, or you find yourself, you know, doing 50 credits or something, give us a call on the 800 number at 888-626-6750, Or send in an email to help and send us a contact line. Say you want to buy more than 50 credits and we'll just get in touch with you and do that separately. So, but you just come in here. We're going to close this out. We're going to click the buy credits. So we're going up to the exports tab. We're going to click the buy credits. And then here we'll just pick the amount of the credits that we want to buy. And again, this, if we narrow this all the way down onto the phone, it just looks like this. So, and then once you click the purchase, now I'll try not to rack up a bunch of charges on Eric's credit card. But, okay, so it's just that easy to purchase the credits. So once you have purchased your credits to export, let me drop this down here and I am going to bring my tablet up and we're going to send off one real quick and let's just, we'll see if it comes back. Now, when we send these off to get converted, the amount of time that it takes to come back is going to vary because these are hand rekeyed into another system. Right now, we got CCC in there and I believe that they're getting ready to add Mitchell back to it. So you're going to be able to select which one of the services as more services come available and select which one of those other estimating systems that you would like your mobile tech estimate to be rekeyed in. So we're just going to go to our estimate list. We're going to come up here. We're going to go right into this estimate 611. We're going to use the three dots at the upper in the upper right-hand side. We're going to bring up that right side menu. And don't forget, anytime you want to bring up that right side menu, you can just go from the right side of your screen and just pull the whole screen to the left. And it'll always pull up. And that's either the right or the left menu. But then we're going to go down here and we're going to go to export estimate. Now I'll bring up this pointer really quick here because you've got export history and export estimate. And history is just going to, and I'll explain this in the back office, it's just going to show you everything that you've exported. So we want to use the export estimate. Now, those of you who are watching this and using Android, Zoom doesn't let me make this same connection with Android, so I can't share the Android screens, but it is actually the export estimate and export history are up here above the tax. So they're all still there. They're just in a bit of a different order, and I have absolutely zero explanation as to why. So we can just click the export estimate, and then now most of you, I realize, are going to have an email address already loaded. I do not because this is Eric's test account. So I'm going to go ahead and add my John at Mobile Tech in there. And then obviously you can see that we're going to export and we're going to have Estify convert this into a CCC format. If this vehicle has a sunroof or the panoramic sunroof, then we can mark it right here under the sunroof included. So then it's just a matter of poking that export button. And then you're going to get an email as soon as it comes back. And I'll show you what that email looks like. One mistake I make regularly when I'm doing this, and I want to go through that right now with you guys, is right here in the vehicle info section, we have got the doors part here. Let's get this pointer back up here. Under here, doors, it'll have a selection. Whenever you create a new estimate there, it doesn't automatically load in the number of doors. This is a required field along with this trim level. So doors and trim, if you know you're going to be exporting, and you'll get a pop-up if you do this, because I see this pop-up 7 times when I was prepping for this thing. Make sure you put in that trim and the door levels because they need that for rekeying into. It doesn't matter what system they rekey into. They need that information into there. So do make sure that you are aware when you fill out this. After you scan the VIN, put in the color, go down, put in that trim level and doors. So sometimes the trim level is automatic, but the doors is not. All right. So now let's get back here. We'll shift around just a little bit. Oh, we're poking random stuff everywhere. Oh, nobody else is sharing on this screen. So when you send off your estimate to get rekeyed, after Estify finish with it, you're going to get this email in. So this is just a screenshot of that estimate or of that email. And what you have is you've got two folders down here. Now this AWF folder, this is going to get emailed to whomever you send it to. So if you have the estimator in the system under that client's name for that shop that you want this rekeyed in, they will get a copy of it. And if you want a copy yourself, put it in there. But this is what they're going to receive. And this AWF file is what they're going to download and load into, in this case, it's going to be a CCC. And then you can just keep a copy of this PDF, or they can load a copy of that PDF right on their thing, on their desktop. Sorry. As you can see, there are instructions right through here. If this is going to be the first time this shop has ever loaded up an Estify rekeyed file, they can just go ahead and watch that video and learn how to do it. Estify really makes this simple. Anybody can go to Estify's website and look this up. So, but this is what you're going to get back from your, in your email box. And then you can load that right there. And then it's just as simple. Let's see. Here's one of them that I did just this morning. So this is what you get back in that PDF format. And then this is going to automatically load within that estimating system. And you're going to have the VIN, your year, make, model. And then it's going to come down here and it's going to go ahead and go into all of your repair lines. So, and everything that you put in, you can see I've got the dent count, the size, the oversized dents, all any markup that you put in there is going to get rekeyed right in. And it will just go line by line. And this will show up. So when if you send this off, say you're at a body shop and they use CCC and you want to send this into them, into a CCC format, when they load this into, they will open it up and that shop is then going to need to finalize with their specific set of charges. So Estify can only follow a set of parameters. They don't know every shop and everybody's specific charges, but this gets all the basis of what you wrote. And this ensures that when that goes back in, that that overloaded estimator doesn't miskey anything or miss a line for you when you went through all that work already to write that estimate inside of Mobile Tech. Now I will show you a mistake that I made when I sent one off when I was testing this out just the other day. So this one here, I'd put in the replacement of the hood and was basically just making a close to conventional estimate and gonna have it spit out. But I did not make sure that I had the paint labor. So you can see right here, that was a simple mistake on my part. I did not put the paint labor. So the reason why I'm showing you this is I wanna make it clear that what you send to Estify is exactly what Estify is going to put into that estimate. So there's no interpretation. It is line by line. So what you add or leave off will show. In fact, I think I did one. It's not up here. This one here, I had the replacement of the hood in there. But I had decided to replace the hood later on after the fact, and I did not remove the R&Is. So they had the labor over here, which was the operating system's labor, and then they had my R&I times underneath it because they copied directly through there. So I had to explain that I made that mistake and added that. Now, a note about labor times, because you guys do call us on this. If we look at this estimate here that was rekeyed into CCC and we sent it from Mobile Tech. Now we know MTRX's labor times are not the same as what is found in CCC, Mitchell, or Autotex. The one of the things that we worked with on Estify is that if you have it converted into one of those other formats, those formats are going to be the labor times to use. So if our labor time to replace the hood in mobile tech is different, this in this case, it would be a CCC labor time, and they would be using all of CCC's time. If they're doing it into Mitchell, then it will be all of Mitchell's times. That is who will be the default times. So inside of your back office portal, when you go back into your exports, okay. All right. I certainly hope everything is still up. We'll make sure that it shows here on the other feed. I got a little error pop up on my screen saying everything quit. So, but okay, you got your buy credits here, but here is your export history. It's the very same that you saw when I showed you in the app. So this is going to be all of that, and you can view that estimate. So this is the one, I think this was one of the ones that we showed. So this is what we sent to, yeah, you can see I don't have any paint rates here. So this is what we sent into Estify, exactly the way it was wrote inside of mobile tech. So you can view it, you can double check yourself. And that's how I double checked myself and figured out that I had no labor. So this allows you to review this right there in the back office portal. And I still don't, I've got my email up on another screen. So I'll let you know. Normally it can take anywhere from half an hour to an hour to get one of these rekeyed into another format. So this provides you with your whole list, and you can search out if you're looking for a specific one, you know that it was sent over. I do recommend, I always make sure that I have a copy and get a copy of it back into my system, because people make mistakes. We delete stuff. Accidents always happen. So make sure that you always have a receiving copy of that, because if you need to re-forward that on, you don't want to go ahead and use another credit to get Estify to rekey an estimate all over again. So, all right. Lost my place there for a second. So let's pop back into the app. Okay. So you're just going to go through one more time. We're going to just kind of walk through the whole thing. So we purchased our credits. We were on the website. We purchased our credits. We're going to go in, and then we can go ahead. We can write our new estimate. So, hey, look, we have a bug test. Let's go ahead and just do that one. Now I'm going to manually input a year make model. I always pick on this Camaro because somebody needs to beat up on a mullet. All right. So remember, like I said, select that trim. And then obviously our Camaro is only a two-door and the engine shouldn't be needed. So then we can just go right in, write our hail estimate as normal. We can put whatever add-ons, heck, we can, if you do them all, they're gonna put them all in there. So they're gonna rekey it straight in. We can go right into our R&Is. We're gonna add that hood and the insulator. And we're going to say it's all done. And then we're going to go right back out here to the estimate homepage. And we're going to click those three dots here in this. I need to move this just a bit so I can see. So remember these three dots. And if you're on the phone, they're going to be all the way up here in the corner. If you're on the tablet, they're here in the front. So remember, on the phone, they're straight up in the corner. On the tablet, they are over here in the center. We're going to click those three dots, and then we're going to go down to export. And then make sure you have all of your email addresses. Verify each of them. If you put in a new one, make sure you poke the add. Guilty of not doing that a time or two. Select which one of your export types, which I believe they're getting ready to get Mitchell added back into here. So there's no sunroof on this. And then we just hit the export button. And that's the pop-up you get if you don't have everything filled out. So I believe the Camaro is not going to put in the engine unless I have the VIN number into it. Whoop, wrong button. Boy, I don't even know what size an engine they even put in that anymore. Let's put in. Let's see if it'll go if I do this. We're going to have a great test here today because we're going to find out if I manually input one. I've never manually input. I've always scanned a VIN. So now let's see what we have. Boy, somebody should have done a copy and paste here. Remember, if you have any serious questions on usage, you can always send me an email right there to that address. You watch me type it in over and over and over. All right, so we have to have the VIN number put in there, and I don't have a VIN number handy on me. Oh, wait. All right. We're going to start all over. We're going to do a new estimate. We're going to go back in here on this bug test, and we're going to do this guy. We're going to beat up on our little Toyota. So this time, we're adding the four doors. So you guys get to learn from my mistakes today. It doesn't get any better than that. Remember, I practice this. We put in the four doors. We put in the trim level. We don't need to add the license or the state. We're going to go ahead. We're going to do the hood. Let's see how quick I can do this. We better put in a size to make sure it shows. All right. We forgot to put in the R&Is on that hood. All right. So now we're back here. Now we click the export. We're going to watch me type in my email address one more time. And in case y'all didn't know, if you just hold down the dot on Apple, it brings it up so you don't have to always type in .com. So we're going to add that, and then we're going to go ahead and export. It's real simple when you do it right. And just make sure you have in that VIN number and put in those doors and the engine. Obviously. So in your export history, that is not going to show up. Let's throw that other screen back up here. Now, the only time you're going to see these right here in this export history is after you have received the email back. So once it has been converted into that new file format that you need, only then will it show up where you can review it here. So once you've sent it off, you've received that pop-up that says to check your email. Obviously, you know, it's going to take the time for them to manually rekey this over. So once it's done, then it will show up here. You can't immediately pop in here or into the export history of the app and have it show. So it's going to be not until it is done. And you see, you've got the date. You can search and you can sort, you know, on their time frames. And remember, this is in the back office portal. So you need to log in on the website. That's where you'll purchase the credits and send that on over. So once again, make sure you go to exports, and this is on the desktop. So if you are on the phone or the tablet, it's the hamburgers in the top right. and then over into the exports. And then you can see you've got the buy credits, and then you have each of the files as you went through them. And I, for those of you that have watched pretty much all of these videos or my webinars, number one, thanks. And number two, it just dawned on me today that I should have been showing you the interactive screen involving the back office between the phone and the tablet version. So if you're on tablet, it's going to look like this. On the website, it's going to look like this. Amateur computer guy, that's my own fault. So, okay. So I didn't know quite how long this webinar was going to be. And how much time it's going to go, but they have not sent it back to me. But I will bring up to this. I know there are some of you guys that are looking at this and going, well, I'm not going to pay that and have these estimates converted over. I don't see any reason for that. But I want you to know, technology is always changing. There are going to be changes on this. For those of you who have been doing this, or you had a separate subscription with Estify in the past and was paying them, and you looked at our pricing structure and was shopping it out, you'll notice that our pricing structure has changed. It has dropped down simply because it is in use. So the more that happens, the more that gets done, the lower the costs are going to be, and the faster it's going to start being done. Right now, most of the stuff is manually rekeyed. In the future, we see it going into automation. So there's going to be lots of options. We also see this having unlimited potential when it comes to exporting, as well as possible importing into Mobile Tech RX. We don't know where the future is going to lead us. So don't rule this out. Keep an eye on that. Keep an eye on the videos. You know, if this is right up your alley, but you're not ready to pull the trigger on this yet, then just keep an eye on it and keep an eye on our Facebook page. You know, you can just find us on Facebook at Mobile Tech RX. Keep an eye on our YouTube channel. You just go to YouTube and type in Mobile Tech RX. Hit subscribe, please, and like and follow us on Facebook. By doing that, as we get the more updates and things keep changing, my job is going to be keep getting that information out to you like this. And as it becomes more automated, and hopefully like we're seeing today, we're going on just over a half hour since I sent that off. If we go automated, we could be 5 to 6 minutes, maybe 2 to 3 minutes. We don't really know where the future is going to go as far as what changes can be made, how many other systems can ever get added into it. So don't rule out the Estify. It might actually work for you, and it will save you time and headache and hassle in the future. So, and what I mean by that is we've seen what happens to an estimator during a catastrophic hail event. Let's take this Dallas storm with all this baseball-sized damage. So those guys are massively overloaded, and those are all mostly conventional cars. So when you guys are in the back and you're writing your PDR-only estimates, and you know that that guy, the estimator, is going to rekey that for pretty cheap for a complete car that you're going to do a full hail job on, you can ease that burden on that estimator for that body shop by giving them a version that they can just dump in right into their system, review it, add their company-specific charges, and out the door. And then your stuff is done. You've made life easier for everybody else, and we hope that we are making life easier for you by allowing you to do that right inside of Mobile Tech, just that easy. Write your estimate, bring up the menu from the main estimate, and hit export. So. All right. Well, I'm not seeing any questions. So either I'm really, really good or I'm really, really bad. And please like us, follow us on Facebook. I still suck at Instagram, and that's probably not going to change, but I do look at it on my laptop or on my desktop, not my phone, which is why I suck at Instagram. But do like us and follow us. Hey, look at that. It pays to delay. So, all right. So I just got my estimate back. So one second here. Let me pop some screens around. we're going to go ahead and bring up our desktop number one. Let me get into my email here. So this is the one that we did, yeah, on that Porsche. So let's pop it up right here. So that's how quickly we sent this across. So we've got our hood is in there with our markups, our roof, and you know, we threw in all of these random markups. So they just copied it straight right down exactly the way I wrote it within the system. So there, it's proof. Even though I screwed it up in the app once, it still sends right on through. So you've got this. So now we can actually go in here. Oh, somebody just started just wailing away on the old clicker. So let's bring this on in. And here we see 613, the bug test. And this was the one that we just sent right on over. Oh, this was my Toyota. Shoot, they got a bunch of them done. Wow. I've got random stuff everywhere going here. All right. Refresh the screen. Yeah, my webinar exports. There we are. Porsche Cayenne. Apparently the Toyota is just about done too. Holy cow. Everybody's flying. They're going way faster and I have the realization of what's being done. So there it is. They're on it. You're sending that in. You're getting that rekeyed. If you would like, and I've done this myself, I just have it sent to me and then I forward it on to that estimator. So then they see that email is coming directly from me. Just like this. I got this. This is exactly what you're looking at. Now, the other file, I can't do anything with. I don't have a subscription. That's got to be imported right into the CCC. So, but that's how it works. It's that simple. And there you would have, like I said, right now I just did it into CCC. So that's a file that would be dumped in. That estimate would be able to be opened right on up into that estimator's or that body shop's CCC subscription, or even an insurance adjuster. I can't say that adjuster would ever do it. You're going to want to communicate that with an adjuster. And if you have that close relationship, if you're doing a retail shop and you have that close relationship and the adjuster is willing to do it, I would go for it every day because it just makes life easy. So, all right, guys, gals, ladies, gentlemen, boys and girls, children of all ages. I hope this helps kind of clarify exactly how Estify works, what kind of time frame that you can see it come in. Now, if you send this off, I'm going to tell you this. If you send this off at 4:59, you're probably not getting it back to the next day. Estify just has their people working hours in the morning. And I am at, we're doing this at 12:30 here. Mountain Standard Time. So I sent that off right at 12. We got it back in a half an hour. So pretty darn quick, pretty efficient turnaround, especially, you know, when you guys write those, you know, 80, 90 line estimates, if you got a huge, huge estimate and having that converted, it's going to take a little bit longer. I sent off obviously some very short, fast estimates, but those will take a little bit longer, but man, it does save everybody a lot of stress and hassle. Take care, all, and we will see you all next week.